Hi! Hiyo here with another Space News Update video. This week's been a pretty eventful week with a lot of stuff happening from astronomy to spaceflight, so let's cover it all. The first thing I want to mention is the Bereshit landing. This is a lunar lander probe designed and manufactured by SpaceIL, a private Israeli aerospace startup. A small business in a small country making a freaking moon lander was already impressive enough, but they actually got it out there toward the moon as well. It launched on top of a Falcon 9 back in February and orbited the moon earlier this month. However, the landing did not go to plan. There is a point of no return, after which the spacecraft cannot abort back up to lunar orbit and has to just continue on down to the moon. Unfortunately, what looks like an engine failure occurred and they were not able to reboot the spacecraft in time, and it impacted the lunar surface and made a new crater at quite a high speed. However, let us not downplay the impact that this has had on the private space community. I've been following this for years and years, and there are other teams like this team that were cheering it on who also have their own lunar landers that will be launching and going to the moon as well. The team intends to try again and has secured some funding so that they can make a new version of this lander and just give it another shot. But I'm really rooting for these guys. Okay, next up, the thing you probably know I was gonna talk about. Over the course of several years, the Event Horizon Telescope, which is a collaborative project of 8 different telescopes around the world, came together to form a telescope with an effective radius of the Earth, and were able to image a supermassive black hole out at the M87 galaxy. Now this is just really, 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 really far away, and super small compared to, you know, what we are used to seeing in the night sky. But it also happens to be a super gigantic black hole, so it's the perfect candidate to test out the telescope on. After a press conference on April 10th, they showed this image, the first photograph of a black hole's event horizon that has ever been taken. It's like Interstellar, but you weren't wearing your glasses. What led them to this galaxy, called Messier 87, was that there was this giant shooty bit coming out of the galaxy, like a big blue jet of stuff, which is a telltale sign that something like a black hole was at its center. Now, any matter can become a black hole if you condense it small enough, until it just kind of, the atoms give up and just turn into a soup of denseness. For this to happen in nature, you need a gigantic, really heavy star to undergo supernova, and then the whole inside of it is compressed until it just gives way and turns into a black hole. Now, since there's such a strong force of gravity in one place, you get a lot of other matter circling around, and that stuff is circling around very, very quickly, usually at a fraction of the speed of light. So it's all bumping into each other, it's all slamming around, and it turns into effectively a plasma. So what you end up having is a weird sun, but instead of the sun being a ball, it's like a big stretched out circle called an accretion disk that forms around the outside of the black hole. This provides a really strong source of light for us to be able to image the black hole, and so now we can actually see the place where photons can't come out. Now, space-time works in a kind of a weird way. Everything, all the time, is traveling at the speed of light, except through time. But when we're near a source of gravity, what happens is that kind of, the vector of our direction kind of tilts a little bit. So no, we're not only traveling through time at the speed of light, a little bit of that speed is going into our speed in space, which means that I fall to the ground. A little bit of our time is being traded for our movement through space, and that is why things are attracted to other things in the universe. This is also why if we put clocks on GPS satellites, they immediately go out of sync, because the time up there is a little bit different to the time down here. All right, let's get to Falcon Heavy. I don't even have notes for this. We just had a launch of the SpaceX Falcon Heavy on its first commercial mission and its second flight overall. It was carrying the Arabsat 6A communication satellite to a very high orbit. After separation of the side boosters, they turned around and started burning back toward Cape Canaveral. The center core then detached from the second stage and did its own burn as well, landing 1,000 kilometers away from the launch site. All three boosters landed successfully this time, which was absolutely amazing. Just a ridiculous spectacle to watch these like 16-story tall things landing there. You could walk underneath those engine belts standing up. They're so high off the ground. In addition to the huge first stage boosters, they also recovered the two fairings that encapsulate the payload. They actually came back down under guided thrusters and parachutes and were recovered by being lifted out of the ocean. That's like 90% of the rocket being reused now. Like, it's just the second stage, basically, that they're not reusing on this one. But they have a plan to do that with a new rocket. Starhopper is continuing to test well. They had some issues with some ice building up on some propellant lines, but now they've actually lifted up off the ground. And they're in the process of checking out that engine and removing those tethers to see if they can have it fly properly. But I can't wait to see the developments going on there, and the live streams have just been glorious. Anyway, this has been your space news for today. I have a Patreon if you're interested in that stuff. I just released a video of something JPL actually sent me. I opened a package. I'll also mention that you can join our Discord and our Telegram group now. It's called Escape Velocity. Yeah, thank you for listening to my rambling about space. Do subscribe if you haven't already, and there's a like button too. This has been Hayu. Take care and have a good day. Bye!